Hello, everybody. This is Pastor Phil with Full of Life Ministries. People of God, I am so delighted to be with you all. You see, I'm reminded of a song that speaks to my excitement that I have towards God and what I know about God, that He looks forward to blessing His people. I know, oftentimes we've been given this distorted picture of God, that He's distant and hard to connect with. And many of the misconceptions about God are from individuals who never fully invested any real quality time with the Lord and are quick to give their opinion when in actuality, they're the last people you should be listening to concerning the goodness of the Lord. So listen, the song goes like this. You don't have to worry. Don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. Troubles, they don't last always. For there is a friend in Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No matter what comes my way, my life is in His hands. I know that I can take it. I know that I can stand. So no matter what comes my way, my life is in His hands. That's the confidence we need to have in Jesus. No matter the difficulties, no matter the afflictions that create serious problems in my life, because my life is in His hands, my mentality is that I'm safe and that I'm able to receive God's wisdom to keep my mind in tune with God. Never giving in to the enemy's schemes and traps, speaking against the fears that try to rear its ugly head to make me doubt God, causing me to operate in trepidation rather than operating in faith, to believe that I will succeed in life because of God. People of God, let's walk in the confidence that's been given to us. Can we do that? Yes, yes. Listen, 1 John, the 15th chapter and the 14th verse declares, we live in the bold confidence that God hears our voices when we ask for things that fits His plan. And if we have no doubt that He hears our voices, we can be assured that He moves in response to our call. I want to read that verse one more time because I want it to sink into your spirit. We live in the bold confidence that God hears, He hears our voices when we ask for things that fit His plan. And if we have no doubt that He hears our voices, we can be assured that He moves in response to our call. What I love about these scriptures, God wants us to have a bold confidence. A bold confidence. Daring to trust God's word in the face of what appears to be impossible. God wants us to have bold confidence. Courageous enough to declare your faith in Jesus when others believe you are just simply crazy in thinking the way that you're thinking. God wants us to live in bold confidence that He hears our voices when we ask for things that fits His plan. That's the key. It has to fit God's plan in order for Him to hear your cry, your plea, your prayer. Aha! This is why we have a hard time living for God. We want Him to accept our plans, but our plans may not be in line with His plan. God's word goes on to say, and if we have no doubt that He hears our voices, we can be assured that He moves in response to our call. Our lives are in His hands. That's what this is all about. Listen, it's so good to be with you all. Now listen, family, we are so grateful that you are sharing our ministry with everybody. Please continue to share our podcast. We are believing for this year, 2021, that we will expand to 2,000 new listeners for this year. And we are on track to achieve this goal. New listeners means opportunities for people from all walks of life to be able to hear this message of hope that we believe is coming straight from the throne of God. And because you believe in what we're doing, God is being glorified and lifted up. I also want to invite you all to watch on Sunday mornings at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Full of Life Ministries are now on YouTube. I want to say that one more time. We're on YouTube Live now, y'all. We're excited. We are elated. We are in the early stages. Bear with all of the technical difficulties because we're trying to expand this message of hope to anyone who will be willing to hear God's love for them. So that's every Sunday now, 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Full of Life Ministries are now on YouTube. So please tune in. Tune in. We provide a service each week, prayer, worship, and a brief word to encourage you so your spirits can be lifted and to allow God to do what He does best, is to bless His people. So remember, tune in each Sunday on YouTube Live at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. All right, let's get into today or tonight's episode. Now listen, before I launch, I have a question that I want to ask you. Are you ready for it? I'm glad that you are. Would you consider yourself a confrontational person or a non-confrontational person? Some people have no problem with confrontation. And some people do have problems with confrontation. I know that there are a lot of our listeners who right now understand that this is a struggle for you to confront a situation where you believe that you have been taken advantage of. Yes, you are frustrated with people who continue to take your kindness for weakness, and it appears their goal is to push you, to trap you, to make fun of you, to demean your name, to slander your reputation. And it seems nobody else is pushing you in this type of way. Or maybe it's a situation where you feel inadequate about how to attack a certain issue. And you believe even before it happens, you believe that this will not be a successful outcome. And so you bury it deep inside the crawls of your heart, allowing the situation to fester and grow, leaving it up to chance that what you're dealing with, you just hope it will just go away. This is one of my biggest struggles in life, confrontation. I hate it. You see, people of God, I love everybody. And I mean, I love everybody. I just do. That's how God built me. He built me this way, and I can't help it. And it's okay to love and to show kindness and gentleness and patience and mercy. But there will come a time in one's life when there will be a battle that will have to take place. You can't avoid it. There will be a battle that will take place, and you have to remain true to yourself. And then you have to have the courage to face your obstacles head on. Because there are many occasions, in life where the enemy is trying to attack you and where we are misinformed about a lot of things concerning your relationship with God and how to handle certain aspects in life. You see, people of God, God has given us things to protect our space. God has given us certain attributes, qualities, to protect our space. He wants for us to see things from the perspective of recognizing who you are in this world. He wants us to be territorial when it comes to the blessings that he has given you. And this has to do with our mindset. When it comes to keeping the enemy at bay and to match the devil's intensity with God's intensity. This is when God's power is displayed. And God's power doesn't need our help. So let's get out the way and let God's power do what it does best. Simply put, we are a child of the Most High God. We have been given precedence over the sins of this world. God says in James chapter 4, verses 7 through 10, and this is straight from the Message translation. It says, so let God work his will in you. I want to say that before we continue on. Let God work his will in you. It goes on to say, yell a loud no to the devil and watch him make himself scarce. Say a quiet yes to God, and he will be there in no time. So it goes on to say, quit dabbling in sin. Purify your inner life. Quit playing the field. Hit bottom and cry your eyes out. The fun and games are over. Get serious, really serious. Get down on your knees before the Lord. It's the only way you'll get on your feet. Isn't that powerful? I love this. This passage has to do with our yell. People of God, we have to growl like a lion. We have to roar like a lion. Now listen, they say a lion's roar can be heard 5 miles away. The lion has the loudest roar of all the big cats. You see, the reason a lion roars is because it likes to scare an intruder, maybe another lion, or some predator that may try to bring harm. And there are times when a lion roars when it feels like they are in imminent danger. Or the lion may roar when they are sending a message to let their foes know who they are. God's word says, when we speak against the devil and his schemes, the Bible declares that we are the real lion. So you need to roar against those things that try to intrude your space. It says when we allow God to work his will in us, he reminds us what he has placed inside of us, and God's power makes the enemy flee. But the key to these verses is dabbling in sin. When you dabble in sin, you are more vulnerable to the attacks of the enemy. It goes on to say, purify your inner life. What are you doing to purify your heart, your mind, your soul? What are the steps that you're taking in order to make sure that you are clean and strengthened through your inner life? It goes on to talk about quit playing the field. Most of us try to play both sides of the fence, the good and the bad. We try to be one way in the world and then behind closed door, another way. But you're playing the field and God sees us, sees you. It goes on to talk about get serious. Most of us are just going through the motions rather than really attacking these things that are crowding your space. Then it talks about prayer, and praying each day and seeking God's face. Because prayer opens the door for the possibility of winning every single battle. And the other thing is understanding who you are. Understanding who you are and whose you are. This is just what the doctor ordered for your life. God is saying today that our mindset has to change. We have to change. Our faith has to increase in order to keep our space where God resides, clear of the misinformation that the enemy keeps providing that takes away the lion that's in you. And so today or tonight's episode will reshape our minds and attitudes toward walking in the authority of Jesus Christ. And so today or tonight's episode is entitled A Lion's Mentality. A Lion's Mentality. Now listen, all throughout scripture, we see the significance of the lion. There's a great deal to focus. There's a great deal of focus that God has provided for us to embrace and cherish when it comes to having a lion's mentality. In God's word, lions are known for their strength, for their beauty, and their fearlessness. The power that a lion displays is simply amazing. And there are scriptures that describe God and Jesus as a lion. In the book of Hosea, 11th chapter and 10th verse says, "They shall go after the Lord. He will roar like a lion. When he roars, his children shall come trembling from the west." Jesus is even called the Lion of Judah. Revelation 5:5 says, "And one of the elders said to me, weep no more. Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, has conquered so that he can open the scroll and its seven seals." Today or tonight's episode, God wants for us to not become cowardly towards a lion that will never stand up to God. I want to say that one more time so you can really get this. God wants from us not to become cowardly towards a fake lion that could never stand up to God. And we have to get away from wasting time and energy trying to be something that resembles weakness. It's easy to become weak when you have not put in the time in prayer and fasting to allow the Lord to minister a message that reminds you that Satan does come to steal and kill and to destroy. But our mentality should be about living for Jesus and to operate as a lion. We have to live as a person who's devoted to the plans that God has for your life. We have to demonstrate courage in the face of uncertainty. We have to take care of others by protecting those who are lost because they continue to live in sin. By providing God's truth, it keeps those precious souls away from the wolves that want to have them for dinner. Lions take pride in providing for their families by giving them the love that they need in order to survive this corrupt world. And this love comes from the Lord. And when love is active, the love of God is active, the lion in you roars. Your courage will determine many outcomes that life brings your way. And this is done by submitting your will over to God's will. We just read in James that says, say a quiet yes to God, and he will be there in no time. That should bring us reassurance and confidence. Just saying a quiet yes to God, he will be there in no time. Because the real lion will roar over the dangers in life. Before we continue, let's take a quick commercial break and we'll be right back with the episode entitled A Lion's Mentality.
Hi everyone, I'm Christopher. I'm the editor of Full of Life Ministry San Diego podcast, and I'm here to say if you like what you're hearing and would like to donate, you definitely can. On any of our pages, on our Instagram, on our Spotify, Spreaker, all of that, there should be a button that allows you to donate to our ministry. With your donations, we're able to donate to a variety of different things, COVID relief, or anyone who just may need it in general. That's all for me, so thank you guys for listening and enjoy the rest of the podcast.
All right, we are back. And I want to make a quick announcement. Just a reminder, a musical reminder. Sunday at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, Full of Life Ministries will be on YouTube. So visit us on YouTube on Sundays at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. All right? All right. So let's get into this. Listen, people of God, in order to have a lion's mentality, we have to, number one, be disciplined and stay alert. Be disciplined and stay alert. Now, 1 Peter, the 5th chapter and the 8th verse says, most importantly, be disciplined and stay on guard, because your enemy, the devil, is prowling around outside like a roaring lion, just waiting and hoping for the chance to devour someone. So listen, discipline is a warrior's friend. Discipline gives you the highest chance possible to receive victory in your life. It says, most importantly, see, when you make something of importance, then you'll put in the work. You'll make sure that you're doing all that you can do in order to be prepared for any attacks or anything that will try to invade your space. So most importantly, you can't have the off and on again mentality. You have to be on guard, alert at all times. Discipline can be developed when practiced. Lions are always on guard. always looking around to see if they spot an enemy in their space. Even when nothing appears to be going on, the Word of God declares, stay alert. And what I mean by this is constantly praying to God to give you insight of something potentially that may happen, and He will give you the guidance and protection from the fake lion. It says the devil is prowling around outside. Prowling around outside. He can only get inside if we allow him to get on the inside of our hearts. So guess what? Keep alert. Stay connected to God. And you will win the battles in life. So number one, be disciplined and stay alert. Number two, to understand and having a lion's mentality, you have to understand that the devil or the enemy is not a real lion. He's not a real lion. It says that Satan is prowling around outside like a roaring lion. He's really afraid of you. He really is. And the only way that he can devour you is if he can convince you that you don't have the lion's mentality. You see, people of God, Satan tries to undermine our confidence. He is always trying to sow levels of discord into your life. And his ultimate goal is to get you to stop believing in what God has placed inside of you so you can return to a life of carnality. These are the directions in which he will try to push us. Remember this, people of God, the Lord is by far more powerful than Satan. Having the lion's mentality keeps Satan locked up. Because when you pray, when you cry out to God, when you speak in God's authority, you tame the little lion that's trying to affect your life. So number two, we have to understand Satan is really not a lion. He's acting, appearing like a lion, but he's not a real lion. Number three, a lion's mentality is always applying God's wisdom to every situation. Number three, a lion's mentality is always applying God's wisdom to every situation. Psalms 34 and 10 says, the young lions do lack and suffer hunger, but they who seek the Lord shall not be in want of any good thing. Whoo! People of God, many times we lack and suffer hunger because of our lack of understanding how to attack certain situations and circumstances, and it causes us to lose focus. It causes us to lose focus, creating an advantage to the devil. But when we see God, when we see God's face, He provides for us the knowledge we need to apply wisdom in the areas that gives us the best opportunity to succeed. Number four, having a lion's mentality provides for others encouragement to their fears. Many of us are so fearful because we do not like to confront. 2 Timothy, the 4th chapter, verses 16 through 19 says, when it was time for my first defense, this is Timothy speaking, no one showed up to support me. Everyone abandoned me. Listen, may it not be held against them. The only person that showed up was the Lord. He stood by me, strengthened me, and backed the truth I proclaim with power, so it may be heard by all. He rescued me. Pride opened the lion's jaw and snatched me from its teeth. And I know the Lord will continue to rescue me from every trap, snare, and pitfall of evil and carry me safely to his heavenly kingdom. May he be glorified throughout eternity. Amen and amen. Now listen, when you proclaim to others to have the lion's mentality, it sets up the great opportunities for those who live their life in traps and snares and pitfalls of evil. Your proclamation, your roar is to save others from the areas where people right now are living their life in fear rather than living their life in faith. Satan is not a real lion. And if he's trying to devour you, God will step in and rescue you from its jaws. What I love about these verses is the confidence that Timothy exudes. He says the Lord stood by him. Aren't you glad that the Lord will stand by you in the face of things that are trying to devour your life? When everybody else abandoned me, he goes on to say, just because no one supports you or no one runs to your defense, the promises that God has for us, that God will be there with you every step of the way. And so in closing, let's get back to confronting real life issues with a grace that's only found through Jesus Christ. Let's stop running away from the tribulations in life. Let's get serious about our walk with God. Stop playing both sides of the fence, people of God. Be like a lion. Find the solutions to life's challenges. Be like a lion and become optimistic of your future. Be courageous like a lion. Be instinctive when you recognize the opportunity to solve a problem. Don't wait for somebody else to fix the situation. Walk under the protection of the real lion. Jesus Christ, the Lion of Judah, will save you from the enemy. The enemy is on the outside. That's the good news. Trying to get on the inside of your heart where he can do damage. So the key is allow Christ to protect the space that he has given you to thrive. For the Bible says, it says it best in Proverbs, the 4th chapter and the 23rd verse. It says, keep your heart with all vigilance, for from it flows the spring of life. Change your thinking. This will change your life. A lion's mentality. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this beautiful day that you have blessed us with. We thank you for your love, your patience, your kindness, your generosity. We thank you for continuing to bless us each and every day. We don't ever want to take this for granted, the blessings that you provide for us that overflows throughout our lives. Lord God, I pray for every listener under the sound of my voice that you will continue to help them in their thinking, oh God. Allow for them to believe that when they apply your words to their life, they can attack every situation with the grace and the seasoning that you give us. God, you want us to be the light of the world. You want us to stand out from the rest. You want us to shine. You want us to glow. You want us to be on the offensive rather than being in the defensive. Help us to face our fears like a lion. Help us to keep away the intruders that tries to come in to invade our space. Help us to speak with authority that you've given us, oh God. Help us to rely on your strength rather than our own, and that we will roar against those things that are trying to bring confusion and hardship and heartache, that we will just embrace your teachings and live the life that you created for us. We'll give you all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. We ask all of this in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Listen, people of God, that is it for today or tonight's episode entitled A Lion's Mentality. This is Pastor Phil with Full of Life Ministries. We are so happy that you tuned in this week. I believe God is going to really minister to your soul concerning this lion's mentality. We should not ever be afraid of the enemy. So listen, continue to share the podcast as you have been doing. We are still expanding. Every time I check, we're in another part of the world. It's because of your generosity. So continue to share the podcast. If you are enjoying the podcast, we appreciate your love. If there's anything that we can do to help you along your Christian journey, don't hesitate. Please don't hesitate to email us at fulloflifesd@gmail.com. Once again, fulloflifesd@gmail.com. If you feel led to support us financially in this ministry, you can go to any of our platforms, you can click the button, and you can give whatever the Lord has placed on your heart. Pray about it, seek God, and allow God to speak to you concerning supporting us financially. We are trying to change the world in every aspect that God has provided for us. This is Pastor Phil with Full of Life Ministries. People of God, 2,000 new listeners by the end of this year. We're going to do it with your help. So guess what? Let's continue to do this in Jesus' name. God bless.